All right, Matt, 3 and 8.
Yeah, we got 2 problems.
Okay.
It ain't showing you.
It ain't showing you?
Hey, first and foremost, before we get started, we're going to give all honor and glory and power to
Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem HaKadosh.
Hey, double honors to our elders, our great apostles, the great millstone, rule well, teach well, being a great example to Israel, mind the elect, and peace and blessing to the holy elect on the four corner, pushing the truth and sincerity, that great song. All right, with the GMS Memphis camp, all right, we come with another lesson through the spirit and power of Yahweh Ba'ashem HaShai, man. Alright, I'm gonna hand to the brother Anah. Hope your brother edified. You know why we lay the law down, man.
Yeah, like the title say, God is sower, walk in repentance to salvation, you know? And you gotta be sincere when you repent, you know? So hey, we just gonna get in the scriptures, let the scriptures do the talking a little bit, really, through the spirit power of you, how about Shabbat Shah, you be edified, you know?
Right.
You gotta say Corinthians.
This is 2 Corinthians 7:10. For godly sorrow worketh repentance to salvation.
Wait, to salvation, man. They say repent because the kingdom of heaven is at hand, man. You know? Hey, the doors of mercy is closing, man. The famine of the world is not. Grace is running out, man. And we should be in a repentant spirit daily, man. You know? Go ahead.
For godly sorrow worketh repentance to salvation, not to be repented of, but the sorrow of the world working death.
Right, the sorrow of the world working death, man. You know, they repented of worldly things, man. You know, they gonna bring death, man, because they say the fashion of this world is temporary, man. Those that walk after their lust is death, man. Trying to follow your flesh and shit, man, this leads to death, man.
Yeah, like a worldly sorrow would be like there's New Year resolutions.
Yeah, that's it. You know, try to get right. You know, I'm gonna do this for my New Year's resolution, man. I'm gonna do better. You know, it is worldly, man.
It is, but that's in vain though, cause you're making that to yourself.
To yourself.
You ain't making that to Yahweh Ba'ashem HaShai, which really control you.
God.
You know what I'm saying? Because you making it to yourself is just saying that you got free will. You control your own mind. You control your own action. You don't control your own action. Yahweh Ba'ashem HaShai control your action, man.
That's right.
You know, so the thing that you are doing, the things you have done, the Lord control you to do that, man.
Uh-huh.
You know, that's one thing our people got to realize and understand, man. Yahweh Ba'ashem HaShai, the power is at hand. Mm-hmm. You know? You got it out.
This is Luke 18 and 9. And he spake this parable unto certain, unto certain which trusted in themselves, that they were righteous and despised others.
Yeah, go ahead.
Verse 10.
Because it's really fitting to break it down, you know, the worldly sorrows, you know, repenting, you know, of the worldly matter. Right? Mm-hmm.
Two men went up into the temple to pray, the one a Pharisee and the other a publican. The Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, the Most High, Yahweh Ba'ashem HaShai, I thank thee, and I am not as other men are, extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even as the publican. Verse 12, I fast twice in the week. I give tithes of all that I possess. And the publican, standing afar off, would not lift up so much as his eyes unto heaven.
Why is that? Why didn't he just lift up his eyes like that? You know, he was in that true repentance.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
The contrite spirit, man. He was on that godly sorrow. You know?
But smote upon his breast, saying, God, be merciful to, be me merciful to me, a sinner.
Right, be merciful to me, because
he was sincere.
Right,
that's you know what I'm saying? If I can bring this out real quick, and then he get back to it. It's John 1 and 9, 1 John 1 and 9. If we confess our sin, he is faithful and just to forgive us.
Yeah.
Forgive us of our sins, mm-hmm. and to cleanness unto for all unrighteousness.
And that's what the Lord wants you to do. Confess those sins, man. Do it no more, man.
That's right.
Come. You know? Just confess those sins, man. Be repentant, man. You know?
Mm-hmm. You got to...
Back in Luke 18, verse 14, I tell you, this man went down to his house justified rather than the other.
Right, because he wasn't really in a repentant mindset, man. Uh-huh. He was doing it in vain. He wanted to be, you know, seen a man, basically, man.
Right.
You know, he would lift himself up in front of the eyes of the Lord, basically, man. I fast twice a week. I give my tithes to you, Lord. I thank you, Lord, because I'm not an other man. Mm-hmm. You see? He wasn't really in a repentant mindset, man. You know, praying, you know. He wasn't humble.
Right.
You know?
Come. For everyone that exalteth himself shall be abased, mm-hmm. and he that humbleth himself shall be exalted.
Exactly, man. Because the one that said, the most that be merciful unto me, I am a sinner, he was merciful. I mean, he was humble, man.
Yeah,
exactly. He lift himself up, man. He was of that godless sorrow, man. He was of a working heart, you know?
And can I bring this one out right quick, bro?
Yeah,
this 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance.
Which is talking about the elect. Mm-hmm. Because all the elect and 1/3 of the nation of Israel is going to come to repentance and recognize the work that they have done and repent, man. Mm-hmm. You know, but we got 2/3 of our people, they can continue to be wicked, man. They can continue to be niggas, you know. But that's why I say the Lord is long-suffering to us, man, which is going to the elect, man. Mm-hmm. You know, because we understand that we were brought out of darkness to this marvelous light. We gotta understand we're still in the flesh. You know, the scripture speaks about a righteous man falling 7 times. But when you fall, guess what? You gotta get back up and continue to push, man.
That's right, that's right.
When you push in sincerity and righteousness, man, you don't push that I'm gonna do it again. Then no, we ain't like church people, man, when it's coming down to the truth, man.
Right.
That's what Christians got it messed up at.
Holier than thou spirit.
Uh-huh.
Like he was just saying, the publican thinking that he was good. Well, I'm not like this man because yeah. I pray, I do this, I fast, you know, give tithes, man. That's that holier than now. That's that Christianity spirit, man.
Yeah, blessing
high faith. Yeah, we don't come in that spirit, man. We understand, man. You know, we understand how the Lord deal, man. That's why you got to do it in truth and sincerity, man. Yeah, you have about somebody shouting on your heart, man. But what are you doing in there? You know?
Hey, I'm getting quick and back you up.
You got it.
This go Luke, ahead. You can break it down if you want. But this Luke 5:32, I came not to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. That's what the Lord basically was hanging around. That's who he come for. He came for the meek and the lowly.
Yep.
He ain't come from a person that think they know it all, got it all.
Yep.
You know? He said he called to bring the sinners to repentance, man. You know?
Yep. Lord said he come to heal the sick, man.
So Go ahead.
Nah, I'm just saying, the Lord said he come to heal the sick, man.
Hey, I started 31 for you.
The lowly, the brokenhearted.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. Go ahead. Luke 5:31, and Yahweh Shai answered, said unto them, they that are whole need not a physician, but they that are sick.
See? They that are whole need not of a physician, man.
Yeah.
So if you already got it, if you know, you doing everything right, man, what do you need to repent for, man?
Know-it-all.
I'm already saved. I'm good.
Yeah.
Come on now. That's the wrong spirit to be in, man. We need the Lord to come back and deliver us.
Hey, when they say they already saved, shit, what you need to be saved from? Jacob Trouble comes.
Yeah, that's right.
I got this new car. What is that? That thing gains and godliness, man.
Gains
and
godliness.
Yep.
Lord doesn't kill. How about... doesn't care how much money you got. You got this 3.5 billion house. You know, everything just prosper, go in favor with you, man.
Mm-hmm.
But say, let the favor be shown to the wicked. Lord doesn't care about how much money you got or how you fame you got, man. You really of that contrite spirit, man. You don't want to break your law, statutes, and commandments, man. You know, you want to be obedient to him, man.
That's right.
You know, that 2 Corinthians 7:10, man, of the godless sorrow, man. Because they were tired. They didn't want to go off, you know. But Scripture said, let not your sins weigh you down. You know? Be not over righteous, over much.
I got a quick one. You ain't got this. Proverbs 28:13. He that cover his sin should not prosper.
Hey, he that cover his sins should not prosper, man. Mm-hmm. Him that hide his sins, hide his iniquities, man. Think I'm holy now, man.
Don't confess.
Don't want to confess.
Uh-huh.
Like you brought on John, man.
Yep.
Confess your sins before the Most High. Acknowledge your transgressions and repent, man.
Uh-huh.
And Apostle Paul, he even said, the things that I desire to do, I don't do. The things that I don't want to do, I find myself them doing.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. You know, so Apostle Paul himself admitted that he needed saved from his own flesh.
Right.
You know, he needed Yahweh Shai, so we can establish that new covenant. So
right.
We can get those spiritual bodies and never go off again, man.
God.
That's right, bro.
And it said, but whoso confess it and forsake them shall have mercy.
Mm-hmm.
Have
mercy, man. That's what the Lord
wants,
man.
Repentance. That's mm-hmm.
it, man.
That's right. And mercy be shown unto you. Yeah. That's just like you're going to your mom or your dad. Hey, mom, I know I messed up. That's just like you repenting to them. You know what I'm saying? I messed up. I know I did this. I should not stole the car, but I did to do this. And you know what I'm saying? They have mercy on you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Instead of just being a fucking hard-headed or a bad child, you know what I'm saying? Then they take the cop from you. You on punishment. You can't do this and do that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Or you break a vase in the house. You know, you try to hide it from them.
Yeah.
You go ahead and tell them, I'm going to confess and I apologize. I do anything to make it right.
Yeah, that's right.
And if I may add, that's why Christianity is really Satanism, man, because it comes in the spirit of that do what thou will.
That's right. Yeah. They expect to be wicked. Mm-hmm. Wicked. 6 days a week.
Yeah.
But when here comes Sunday, they can be forgiven.
You go get the suit out, you go get the Bible, dust the Bible off from me. You sitting up all week.
You Christians got it wrong, man. The Lord not a pushover. Hey, what they call it, he not a sugar daddy.
Yeah.
Hey, the Lord is not that, man.
That's right, bro.
You know, y'all need to get y'all mind right when y'all thinking and talking about you have about Shema Shah, man. You're not a pushover, man.
It's on Isaiah chapter 66, verses 1 and 2. Thus saith the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah, the heaven is my throne, and the earth is my footstool. Where is the house that ye build unto me? And where is the place of my rest? Verse 2. For all those things hath mine hand made, and all those things have been, saith the Lord.
Exactly.
But to this man will I look, even to him that is poor and of a contrite spirit, and trembleth at my word.
Hey, God, hey, read that again. God said, to this man will I look. You go to the word look, it's Nabat, which means to regard with care, man, to show favor on, man, of a contrite spirit, man, brokenhearted, man.
Come. You read again?
Yeah, read again.
Come. Verse 2. For all those things hath mine hand made, and all those things have been, said the Lord Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah. But to this man will I look.
Like what I have respect on, that I would have care for,
Come. Even to him that is poor and of a contrite spirit.
Man. Humble. Mm-hmm. Contrite spirit, man.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to avoid their sins. Like they want to walk in righteousness, but it's hard for them, man.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I keep sinning, man. Please, Lord, forgive me for my iniquities, man.
Right.
Just like we eat something with pork and we didn't know.
Yep.
You know, we feel off, man. Like, come on, please don't let me do that again, Lord.
Forgiveness.
Ask for forgiveness, man. You know?
That's right.
But we don't want to do it willfully, man. We don't want to do it. We're trying to, we said we host the righteous acts,
That's
right. We're trying to be perfect. Like I said, be there for perfect in heaven, your Father in heaven is perfect. We're from paraphrasing it, Matthew 5:48, I believe, man.
Yeah.
But we try to be perfect, man.
And that's what it's about. That's why when you're going to John, he said, going to the book of 2nd Ezra, he said, we labor, all right, to be made perfect.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So these things, and the way we are, we labor to be made perfect, man. We rehearsing the righteous act.
Mm-hmm.
Because what? Practice what? Make perfect.
That's right. Yeah.
So going through these tribulations and these trials that you have by Shema Shah putting us through, we going through this to be made perfect, man.
Yeah. And also say all our righteousness is up here to rest.
Right.
You know, but we still try to keep it to the best of our ability,
exactly.
Man. We don't want to go off, man.
Uh-huh. Back to what? Romans 8:20. The creature was made subject to vanity.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Not willing, because we don't willing to go off, man. Who want to go off, man?
Yeah.
You know, we don't willing to go off, but the Lord created us to do that because we have hope and have mercy and call upon Yahweh Shemal Shah, man.
Yeah, and that's why the kingdom of heaven gonna be so beautiful, man. Cause it say the wages of sin is death, man. We don't want to die, man. We want everlasting life, man.
Hey, they gonna even be in our even thought of going to.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, the brother Yasha had said something the other day on his live. He was just saying like how we not even gonna forget. You know what I'm saying? You know how Jake is on this side. You forgetting stuff. This man, we ain't gonna forget nothing.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's beautiful.
We're gonna be walking, living Bibles, man.
Right.
And whenever we see wickedness, man, we're already on top of it.
Yep.
You know, passing judgment on it.
That's good.
While quoting their sentence.
Man, perfect.
That's the new covenant, man.
That's it.
The law, statutes, commandments in us, man. That's what we want, man. Not to go off, man. That the Lord deal with us forever, man.
Right, bro.
You know?
God.
You got something?
Yeah, just it had a point you had made about the wages of sin, but it's about the wages of righteousness. As for the, this is Wisdom of Solomon 2:22. As for the mystery of the Most High, they knew them not. Neither hope they for the wages of righteousness, nor discern their reward for blameless souls. For the Most High created man to be immortal, and made him to be the image of his own eternity.
Read it again.
This is Wisdom Solomon 2:22. As for the mystery of the Most High, they knew them not. Neither hope they for the wages of righteousness, nor discern their reward of blameless souls. For the Most High created man to be immortal and made him to be an image of his own eternity.
Yep. Hey, he made man to be immortal, man. Mm-hmm. Image of his own eternity. So that's what we're gonna go back to, man.
Right.
We're getting the kingdom, man. We're gonna be like living gods, man, on the earth, man.
Yeah. When you go back to the word God, you go back to what the ruler, the judge, the divine one, going back to the angels.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Really the elect. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's beautiful, man. Hey. To be able to, to be able to, you know what I'm saying, be those first fruits, man. Lord willing, that can come back into the earth and man know, hey, we not, you know what I'm saying, we gonna rule forever, man.
Yeah.
This it,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying, that everlasting life, man, eternity, man. You know
all the sorrow we've been through, all the trials and tribulations.
Come on now,
you know that we went through. Those are the wages of righteousness.
Yep.
You know that we have received immortality. That's one of them. What you got it up?
Hey,
yeah, come. This is Matthew. I thought you had 21.
Oh yeah. You still got the Matthew 21?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Slide.
Go to.
You started
28.
Okay. Slide. This is back in Matthew 21, and verse 28. It reads, "But what think you? A certain man had two sons." And he came to the first and said, "Son, go work today in my vineyard." He answered and said, "I will not." But afterward, he repented and went.
Hey, see? He told his father no, but he repented
and went
and done what his father said. He did the will.
Go ahead. Verse 29 again, it said, "He answered and said, I will not." But afterward, he repented and went. And he came to the second and said likewise, and he answered and said, "I go, sir," and went not.
Right, he didn't go. He said he was going to go. Yeah. He said, but he never did.
Verse 31, whether of them twine did will of his father.
Right, the Lord asking them, which one of them did the will of their father? The first or the second? Go ahead. He asked them to the disciples the question, right?
Yeah.
Verse 31 again, it says, whether of them twine did the will of his father, they say unto him, the first. Yahweh Shai said unto them, verily I say unto you, that the publican and the harlots go into the kingdom of the Most High before you. For John came unto you in the way of righteousness, and ye believe him not. But the publicans and the harlots believe him, and ye, when ye had seen it, repented not afterward, that ye might believe him.
That's the point, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Oh, okay, you got it. Matthew 3 and 8.
Yeah.
Bring forth therefore fruits meet for repentance.
Right, man. Mm. Hey, man. Bring forth fruit meet for repentance.
Don't go on the highways and the edges, man.
Don't stay sincere, you know?
Yeah, that's right. Because you got to remember, this Acts 5 and 31, he have the power exalted. Him have power, which is the Most High, have exalted his right hand, which is Yahushua, to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sin.
He said for to give repentance to Israel.
Yeah.
Who make up Israel? You so-called blacks, Hispanics, Latinos, and Native American Indians into the Israelite fauna, so they scattered amongst the countries and like the other nations, man. It didn't say to everybody.
Uh-huh.
Repentance is for the nation of Israel, man. Uh-huh.
Yep. So bring that back out again, Colossians.
Matthew 3 and 8.
Yep.
Bring forth therefore fruits meet for repentance.
See? Which is what Israelites, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because only the Israelites can repent.
That's right.
And it start with the elect. That's why we fishing for the elect, man. Because once the elect gets sin, we going home, man. We gonna get the new bodies, man. We gonna get the crowns, man.
Man.
Right. Really, we all that chosen.
That's right.
You see?
That's right, bro.
You know? You bring that up.
God, this is a Psalm, chapter 51. I'm going to start at verse 16. It says, "For thou desirest not sacrifice, else would I give it. Thou delightest not in burnt offering. The sacrifices of the Most High are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart."
Hey, yes, the sacrifices of the Most High is a broken spirit and a contrite heart, man. You know?
Yeah.
Those that acknowledge they are false. You know, they're transgressors, you know? We say, in all their ways, acknowledge the Lord, and He shall lead thee, follow us straight in. You know?
It was right here, Ezekiel 14 and 6. "Therefore say unto the house of Israel, thus said the Lord, Yahweh Shemosh, our power, repent and turn yourselves from your idols."
Mm. Yep. And your false gods. You know.
Money, cars, clothes, whatever. Mm-hmm. Like you say, whatever you put your heart into, that's an idol,
that's
man.
Right. That's right.
You know, whatever you put above Yahweh Shemosh, you know, that's an idol.
Hey, if I can say this too, man, you got to think, man, the Lord is all powerful, man. So he want to get glory in you know, exalting himself through you, man.
Uh-huh.
So if you had a point like a guy like Lil Wayne or some of these rappers, a person who already got it, man, he ain't going to get no glory in it.
Nah,
he want the lowly. He want the meek. He want somebody that, the underdog, man. Somebody ain't nobody paying attention to, ain't nobody looking at. That's who he going to shine through. He going to like, man, this guy? Mm-hmm. Hey,
not many mighty.
This was a prophet. This was a man the Lord was dealing with the whole time.
Is this a little more here? Yep. "And turn yourselves from your idols. And turn away from your faces from all your abominations."
Yeah.
That's going back to repentance, man.
Right.
Like we were reading earlier, you got to open up, man, to Yahweh Shemosh, repent for your sins, and start moving forward, man.
Right.
You know? Because like you say, how can a man be cleansed by what? The washing of the word.
The
word will cleanse you and clean you, man, from your filth. Because once you come to the knowledge, when you understand Yahweh Shemosh, He gonna wipe away everything that you done before.
Let me get this for you. This Acts 3 and 19, it says.
Yeah.
Oh, Salaki.
It's all good. Bring it out. The spirit, man.
Salaki, bro. It says, "Repent ye therefore and be converted."
See?
That your sin.
How can you do that? You gotta be cleansed by washing the word first. That's how you be converted, because when you go into what that is, Ephesians 5 or Ephesians 4 and 26, concerning that old man.
Yeah, take out the old man.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta take out that old man, you being converted.
Yep.
You know, cause brother can look up that word converted right quick.
Yeah.
Got no converted mean like a crossover. Or going to a change.
This is a word converted, it means having been adapted to be suitable for a new purpose.
See, a new purpose.
New purpose.
Well, what's our new purpose? To push the truth.
That's
gospel. That's good news. That's our purpose. Because we once was had our own purpose in life. You know what I'm saying? We want to talk this right here. You know what I'm saying? preaching and teaching the Bible, going out fishing. But we weren't taught that. We were teaching that. We had to get a wife,
yeah,
a white picket fence, yep, dogs, some kids, yep, and live the American dream.
Yeah.
That was our purpose in life until what the Lord brought us a new purpose, which mm-hmm, to push what? Forth this word, man.
That's right.
Go ahead.
It says, cause to change in form.
Yeah, change in form. Go ahead.
Character or function.
See, what changed our character? This word. Yeah. What cleans you? The washing of the word. Because once you get clean from this word, then you become a whole what? New person.
Yeah.
Your
new
character creature had changed from being in the world.
Yep.
Yeah. And I get this scripture back up.
Go ahead. Hey, keep that. We're going to go down some more on the definition. Keep that.
This Hebrews 10:22. Let us draw near with a true heart and full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience, and our bodies washed with pure water.
Man, that's the word. Yeah. The washing of the word.
Hey, it ain't that getting dipped off in the water.
Out of the church shit. Christianity. Yeah, 2 seconds dipping.
Get back out the water like, damn, I don't feel no different.
Right. No, it's still doing the same shit you were doing yesterday.
Shit, man.
That's right. You know? Go ahead with the definition, a little more on the definition.
Some other similar words to it, change, turn, or transform.
See? Transform. Mm-hmm.
And be renewed in the spirit of your mind.
Exactly. Come. Right, brother. That's beautiful.
It says reshape, refashion, remodel.
Read. You know what I'm saying? Read. Okay. Everything is read.
Yep.
Now we're coming back to who we really are.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Yep. And that's the power behind Bashem Al-Shah. Yep. Because he said that, man. He's gonna set us up. Before their eyes, man, the apostles, great millstone down to Lee's brother, we've been sick, man. The Lord has brought back the prophets, man. This is the season of the prophets, man.
Yeah.
You know? So we all coming back into our lot of who we was in our past life, man.
Yeah.
You know?
He said, I would make a man more precious than fine gold.
Man.
Through that fire, man.
Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. That's right. Being renewed daily. It says, examine yourself daily, lest you be in the faith, or lest you be whipper-based, man. You see?
Yeah. You got it? Is it a little more?
Yeah, this is it.
Okay, go ahead.
This is Job. Okay, all right. This is Job 33 and verse 27.
Yeah.
He looketh upon men, and if any say, I have sinned, and perverted that which was right, and it profited me not, he will deliver his soul from going into the pit, and his life shall see the light.
Mm. Read 27:28 one more time.
Come, this is Job 33 and verse 27.
Mm-hmm.
He looketh upon men, and if any say, I have sinned, and perverted that which was right.
Right, you know? He say, look upon men. And if they say, I have sinned, I have transgressed the law.
He repented.
He acknowledged his sins. He confessed his sins, man. Yeah. You know, I perverted that which was right.
Yeah.
I went out the way of righteousness, man. I forsook the laws, man. Mm-hmm. I forsook the voice of the Lord, man.
Mm-hmm.
But it say, repented. You know, and it said, profit me not for not going over, chasing this thing, man. You know? It didn't help me. It didn't benefit me. Basically, man. You know, for forsaking the way of righteousness, man. Go ahead.
Verse 28. He will deliver his soul from going into the pit,
which means in the grave for death, because the wages of sin is death.
Right.
Go ahead.
And his life shall see the light.
Which is salvation.
The light.
Yeah. The kingdom of heaven, basically. That's the light.
I'll give
1
Peter the second chapter.
Right, I think I'm going to have to find it.
Go ahead.
This is 2 Samuel. It's kind of lengthy.
Go ahead.
Okay, this is 2 Samuel 12, and I'm going to start at 1. It says, and the Lord sent Nathan unto David, and he came unto him and said unto him, there were two men in one city, the one rich and the other poor. The rich man had exceeding many flocks and herds, but the poor man had nothing save one little ewe lamb, which is like a baby lamb, which he had bought and nourished up, and it grew up together with him. And with his children, it did eat of his own meat and drank of his own cup, and lay in his bosom and was unto him as a daughter. So, you know, this ewe lamb was like a pet. You know, it's like almost like, you know how people without any kids and they get really attached to their pets. It says, there came a traveler unto the rich man, and he spared to take of his own flock and of his own herd and dress for the wayfaring man that was come unto him, but took the poor man's lamb and dressed it for the man that was come to him. You know, because he was rich, he took the poor man's lamb and he said, well, I can just pay it over, you know, sixfold, you know, which was according to the law whenever you steal something. You know, but he had the means to just cover the charge, so he just took it, even though that was a really personal lamb to that man. And, you know, verse 5, it says, and David's anger was greatly kindled against the man. And he said to Nathan, as the Lord liveth, the man that hath done this thing shall surely die. And he will restore the lamb fourfold because he did this thing and because he had no pity. And Nathan said to David, thou art the man. Thus saith the Lord, power of Israel, I anointed thee king over Israel and delivered thee out of the hand of Saul. Mm-hmm. So Nathan made him realize that, hey, you're that man, because you had, who was it, go off into battle and die so you can take that man's woman. But, you know, this is a point, verse 13. It says, and David said unto Nathan, I have sinned against the Lord. And Nathan said unto David, the Lord hath put away thy sin, and thou shalt not die. Mm-hmm. So that's all it took for David, to admit that he was that man.
Right.
And that he was worthy of death, because it was out of his own mouth that that man is worthy of death and he right. should pay four times.
Right.
You know? But, you know, that was just the point that I wanted to make, that, you know, King David repented.
Right.
He was of that broken and contrite heart, because he also wrote that psalm in Psalm 51. You know? Yep. Thou delightest not in sacrifice, yep. like King Saul did. You know, he would steal the animals that he conquered when the Most High gave him a straight commandment to put those flocks to death because they had blemish. But he took them as sacrifice to make a sacrifice to the Lord. But the Lord doesn't want sacrifice. He just wants you to do righteousness, man.
He said obedience is better than sacrifice. Yeah. I get a precept back you up, and we get to Ezekiel. This Psalms 32:5, I acknowledge my sin, and this is King David, you know. He said, I acknowledge my sin unto thee, and my iniquity have I not hid. I said, I will confess my transgressions unto the Lord, and thou forgavest the iniquity of my sin, man.
Yep. That's right, because let me get this precept back up.
RV6, for this shall everyone that is godly pray unto thee in a time when thou mayest be found. Mm-hmm. Surely in the floods of great waters that should not come down unto him, man. And he said Esau in for to come like a great flood,
that's
man.
Right. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
So it's that time to repent, man. Acknowledge those sins and continue repenting, man. And do it no more, man.
Like the church say, the doors of repentance is open.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? But it is. Yep. Because it represents that ark. Alright, going back to the time of Noah.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? When Noah was out there telling people that it was going to rain, that was a time of mercy, that the repentance time was near.
Yep.
But then nobody listened, just like majority of the people right now. They're not listening.
Right. Listen.
But so when the Lord closed the door of repentance, then when everybody going to want to get it.
Yeah, it's over.
Because Jake tell you that it's natural to see that Jake is a last minute dude.
Yeah.
You know, you got to prove Jake that on time all the time. But majority of Jake, you know what I'm saying, the world, they always late. You know what I'm saying? They always late. You know what I'm saying? I know personally, my brother, he always say, you ain't shit if you ain't late. You know what I'm saying? It just coming. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, man.
Yeah.
You know? So that time come when you late, your ass late.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Ain't no opening no door. You know, the Lord got to see him. And that's why he bring his prophets to prophesy and warn you of the destruction and the dreadful day that's approaching the earth now.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, when time comes, you can't say that you ain't have time to do so.
Right, that's right.
You know, and you can't bag him. He don't want to listen because he ain't coming to talk. That's why the doors of repentance is open now unto Israel, man.
That's
Right. Which consists of so-called Negroes, Latino, Native American, Hispanics, man.
Yeah, that's
right, bro.
You know?
Yeah, but if you're not sincere, man, hey, Lord will get rid of you, man. Yeah. That's a
right.
Thing, man.
That's right.
You know?
It's 2 Chronicles 30:9, Babakashah. For the Lord Yahweh, your power is gracious and merciful. Because throughout the scripture, he said, Yahweh Shema Shahweh said, his hand is stretched out still.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Through all the hell he done put us through, he still have mercy on us.
Yep.
You know, he could have did even worse to us.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? It said, for the Lord Yahweh, your power is gracious and merciful, and will not turn away his face from you if ye return unto him.
If ye return unto him.
Return unto him.
So, hey, just like David just did, man, you got to repent and come back into the Lord, man.
Yeah.
You know? And the Lord will have mercy on you, man. I got a quick precept.
Go ahead.
This is Isaiah 55:3. It says, incline your ear and come unto me and hear, and your soul shall live, and I will make an everlasting covenant with you, even the sure mercies of David. Like the brother just read, man, you know, David got mercy from the Lord, man. Mm-hmm. He was supposed to be put to death, man, for what he did. But the Lord showed him mercy, man. And that's what he's doing with the elect, man. You know, he's going to get an elect, the sure mercies of David, man. The house of David. That's what we're building, man. Right now. You know, that's the elect. Lord willing, we are a part of that number, man. Lord willing, we chosen, man. We can get that mercy, man. Because, hey, what's coming upon the earth, man, that's what you want, man. You want to have mercy from the Heavenly Father, man. You know?
I got a quick one. It's on Matthew 4:17. From that time, Yahweh began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
And we see it now. How we know? Because prophecy is speaking. He said, when these things begin to come, lift up your heads, because the redemption draw nigh. Luke 21:28, man. Prophecy is speaking. This is how we know at the end. We're at the end of this, man.
That's right.
Talking about another shutdown, famine, plagues, you know.
Wars,
man. Earthquakes, diverse places.
Just like the prophets of old.
That's right.
You gotta remember. The prophets of old prophesied the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
The downfall of their great kingdom. And what we doing? We prophesied the downfall of this great kingdom.
That's
right. Babylon the Great, which been the golden cup in Yahweh's hand, man.
Mm-hmm.
The Lord made this, made America great, man. You know? The Lord Yahweh made America great, man. Did nobody do this but the Lord, man.
That's right.
But what? His purpose. Like he said, he raised up Pharaoh for his purpose.
Hey,
right.
His purpose.
Or would he say he ruled in the kingdom of man?
Yeah.
The king is in his hand.
That's right.
You know? The boy get that Ezekiel.
Oh, come. This Ezekiel 18:27. It says, again, when the wicked man turneth away from his wickedness that he have committed and doeth that which is lawful and right, he shall save his soul alive.
Hey, that's, we all did that, man. We all were doing wickedness in the world, man. That's why I say he called us out of darkness to his marvelous light, man. But we all were doing something wicked in the world, man. Even the shortest thing getting lined up, they're still being wicked.
Yeah,
because
it's
contrary to what? The scriptures.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Eating pork. Committing adultery, we all were doing something wicked.
Yep.
But read that again, huh?
It says, again, when the wicked man turneth away from his wickedness that he have committed,
man,
and doeth that which is lawful,
man,
and right, he save his soul,
man,
alive.
Man, you got a chance to do that, man.
Yep.
We doing it. And you brought up that the spirit resonate with y'all's spirit. Y'all have a chance to do it, man.
Yup. It said, get diligent to make your call and let your soul, man. We got that chance, man.
Yeah.
You know, but it say, cursed be ye that do the work deceitfully, man.
Yeah.
We don't want to do the work of the Lord deceitfully, man.
That's right.
You know the judgment of that, man.
He's
going to spew you out of his mouth, man.
Uh-huh.
What it say, Jew, the folk, man crept in on the world.
Well,
that's a scary thing, man.
Yeah, right,
Judas
right.
Betrayed the Lord. We don't want to be Judas, man.
Yeah,
We want to endure to the end, man.
That's right.
Yeah.
You know,
saved,
we want to be saved, man. You see?
Right.
No, keep going.
It says, because he considereth and turneth away from all his transgressions that he have committed, he shall surely live, and he shall not die.
Right, he said, but he considereth, man. He acknowledges it, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
Keep going?
Yeah.
It says, yet saith the house of Israel, the way of the Lord is not equal. O house of Israel, are not my ways equal? Are not your ways unequal?
Right, and that's the Lord asking the house of Israel, because this our people, man. God, the Lord ways ain't right, it ain't filled. Right. The scripture say his laws are not grievous, man.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You see, the Lord ain't right, man. Like Lil Boo's a badass, man.
Yep.
About the pork situation, now look at him, man.
Now look at him.
Leg about to get chopped off, call him out, just want to shop for that. But hey, this our people, though, man.
Yep.
Give us a king like the heathens. Hey, what the Lord did. And gave us a king, and we seen it didn't fucking work, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
The Lord's way is not equal, man. Until this day, man. The Lord doesn't care. Why would the Lord do this to his own people? This our people. Why would the Lord put me in the slums? Put me in the trap?
Mm-hmm.
Why do I catch the hell out of me, man?
Mm-hmm.
Cause you continue to go off, man.
That's right.
You know?
It say, it's like Revelation 3:19. As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten. Be jealous, therefore, and repent.
That I love, I rebuke and chasten, man.
Yeah.
That the Lord love, he chasten. If you endure chastening, I
do you as I did with sons.
You are my sons indeed.
Yeah.
If not, you're a bastard, man.
Uh-huh.
You know?
He said, be zealous. Therefore, and repent.
Repent, man. The Lord wants us to repent.
That's it, man.
And hey, the grace is running out, man. And our people still don't want to repent, man. They still want to vote on Sleepy Joe.
Yeah. It's on the hourglass.
Yeah.
You know, you flip the hourglass.
Running out of time.
That's right.
Yeah, just the back of the brother. This is 2 Maccabees 7:32. It says, for we suffer because of our sins. And though the living Lord be angry with us a little while for our chastising and correction, yet shall he be at one again with his servants.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
This is 2 Maccabees 7:32.
Go ahead.
For we suffer because of our sins.
Damn.
And though the living Lord be angry with us a little while for our chastising and correction, yet shall he be at one again with his servants.
It's just going back to say we suffer by our sins, because 2/3 of our people don't even know why they're suffering.
Yeah.
But get what I say, the truth shall what? Set you free.
Right.
You understand?
And he said a little while, man.
Yeah.
A moment.
It's light affliction.
I was walking my people for a moment. And I gave it into their hands.
Yeah, just for
a moment, man. Just a little while, man.
And there's light affliction on the floor.
Yeah, light affliction on the floor.
You got it.
Yeah.
Bring it real quick.
Romans 8:18. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us.
Ooh.
Hey, it's especially, you know, it's hard to admit that, you know, you go off and that you're wicked. But man, it's so much better to get it off your chest and, you know, come back to the law, statutes, and commandments, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yep.
Yeah, I got one real quick. This is 2 Maccabees 6:12. Now I beseech those that read this book that they be not discouraged for these calamities, but that they judge those punishments not to be for destruction, but for a chastening of our nation, man. Slavery. It's chastening of us because we transgress his laws, man. That's why we underneath the curses, man.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know?
I got it, bro. This 2 Corinthians 4:17. It says, for our light affliction, which is but for a moment.
Man, the light affliction, which is but for a moment. It's not a lifetime that what we're going through, man. You know?
Mm-hmm.
But don't take it lightly either. Mm-hmm. You know? That's one thing about it. Don't take it lightly because this is only for a moment. That's why Jake got that dude die with spirit. They become more wicked than the wicked because Jake like, shit, I'm going to die anyway, or shit, I'm going to go to heaven anyway. You don't have that type of spirit, that mentality, man.
Yep.
You know, you got to have that repentant mentality, man. No, you got it out. I'm just saying you got to have that humble spirit upon you, man. It said, that's why I said don't take that lightly, because it's like affliction's only for a moment. Yep. And we catch a hell, but shit, once we get to, you know what I'm saying, the afterlife, shit, we gonna be good. You know, no, that ain't the type of spirit to have, man. Mm-hmm.
Or be like, shit, I'm still an Israelite. I'll be king.
That's a nigga spirit, man. That's a nigga spirit. And the Lord, a really put the hammer down on your ass, man. Show that you wish you never said that. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, this light affliction that we going through is on for a moment, because we only really going through it for about 100 years. You know what I'm saying? But the kingdom of heaven, what, it's forever. So it is for a moment. This shit like a dream, man. When we go to sleep, what? 6-7 hours, we dream.
Nightmares.
We wake up like, you know what I'm saying? This how us being in America gonna be, man. Like a fucking dream, man, compared to the kingdom of heaven. Right. It's gonna last forever and forever and forever, man.
Yeah. Be in the kingdom of heaven, like, damn, man. That shit, Esau, whoop my ass.
Yeah.
I'm gonna fuck him up for this.
Yeah. Make him pay for this, man.
Yeah, go ahead, y'all. Yeah,
it said, working for us, a far more exceeding and eternal way to glory.
See, that's it, the kingdom of heaven, man. Yep. It's way more better and precious than America, man. Mm-hmm. Selling your soul.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Being a yeser man. You know, it's way better than that, man. You know, you yeser till you have Hashem out of shot, man. Because he your deliverer, he your savior, man.
But it said we rather, we ought to obey the Most High. We're ready to the man.
Right.
If you take that chip, you're going to get destroyed.
It's over with. It's over with. Don't trust in your oppression, man. Trust in your Habashim Shah, man. You know?
That's right.
We're going to end on that. It's a little more.
It's a little more on this Ezekiel. Ezekiel 18 and 30. It says, therefore I will judge you, O house of Israel, everyone according to his ways, said the Lord, power, repent and turn yourselves from all your transgressions, so iniquity shall not be your ruin.
Right, it should not be your downfall, man. Cause that's our kryptonite, man. And Esau know that, man. Mm-hmm. But then Judah 5, and, the 5th chapter, I believe, the accuser of our brotherless, man.
Yeah, yeah,
they know us going off is our downfall, man. You see? But in the kingdom of heaven, we're not going to sin no more.
Yeah.
So the Lord will be dealing with us forever, man.
Hey, hey, it's like Superman ain't no more kryptonite, man.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? You get rid of all the kryptonite, man. Superman just, hey, he just for the domination.
Invincible.
He invincible. Yeah. Ain't no stopping him, man.
Yeah.
It's over with.
This is the book of Sirach 17 and 24.
Yeah.
It reads, but unto them that repent, he granted them return and comfort those that fail in patience.
Yeah, keep going.
Return unto the Lord, Yehovah Hashem, Yehovah Shai, and forsake thy sins.
Right, forsake thy sins, man. That's beautiful, man. He said he granted them return, man. What it say? You have played the harlot. Jeremiah, the 3rd chapter.
Yeah.
But yet, return unto me again, O backslide Israel. Don't repent and face me, man.
That's right.
Lord just want us to all return, man, and forsake our sins. Like these grace people, they think, like especially Christians, they say the Lord nailed that to the cross. I can eat this lobster. I can eat this crawfish. I can get this headline.
Right.
The Lord nailed that to the cross. Do you love the Lord? Hey, go to John 3:16, close the books.
Yeah.
You know?
That's the case.
Yeah. That's exactly what they doing.
Yeah.
But we ain't supposed to do that, man. They said, yeah, we established the law.
Yeah,
Romans 3:31.
That's right.
Romans the 6th chapter. You know?
And we honor the law, man. Mm-hmm.
We honor grace, but the grace is for us to get right, man.
That's right.
Come on.
You know?
Come on.
So, like, you do it by then, avoid the law through grace.
Most happy. This is Sirach 24. But unto them that repent, he granted them return and comfort those that failed in patience.
Yeah, failed in patience, go ahead.
Return unto the Lord, Yehovah Hashem, Yehovah Shai, and forsake thy sins,
right.
Make thy prayer before his face, and offend less.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Keep that's it. All you asking.
Turn back to him.
And pray, man. Humble yourselves, man.
Good. Verse 26, turn again to the Most High, and turn away from iniquity, for he will lead thee out of darkness into the light of health.
Into the light of health, man.
Beautiful.
He said his word is a lamp unto my feet. Mm-hmm. He is the light, man.
Which is the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Because this is your salvation.
That's right.
What's that wisdom and knowledge to be what? To be the time. This is your salvation right here, man.
That's it, man.
You know? Ain't nothing that's going to be able to hold you in that day. Ain't nothing that's going to be able to save you but having this knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, man. You know, progression and a name. Okay? That's what's going to save you, man.
Like 1 Peter said, he imparted thee out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Yeah.
They said, hey, you got to continue praying and no fasting and doing, man. You know? And I speak of myself chiefly, man. We come into evil times, man. You want the Lord to be protect you, man.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah, because these people still in darkness, man.
That's right.
You know?
Go ahead.
It's like
that. Hey, yeah, because if we suffer, it should be for righteousness' sake.
Yeah.
But back in Sirach 17:26, turn again to the Most High and turn away from iniquity, for he will lead thee out of darkness into the light of health and hate those abominations.
Vehemently.
Vehemently.
Yeah, man. Hate those abominations. You know, fast, man. Hate it. Fast, man. You know, we see somebody eating pork. Ah, man, can't watch this shit.
Yeah.
You know, like the YouTube, the girl on YouTube got the big ass lobster.
Oh, yeah.
I can't watch that shit, man. That shit just disgusting, man.
Yeah,
you know?
Bullshit.
God, we got it on Luke 15.
This is Luke 15:10. Likewise, I say unto you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of the Most High over one sinner that repenteth.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So there's a lot of praises going on. 144,000 plus one third.
Yeah.
A lot of praises going on in the heavens, man.
That's right.
All right, for the elect being sealed, man. You know, just think about it. All the angels rejoicing over
one.
One sinner.
You know what I'm saying? Over one sinner that repent, man.
God.
And come back to the knowledge and wisdom of the understanding of Yahweh Shemal Shah, man. Mm-hmm. And continue and start to rehearse the righteous acts, man. You know? And that's what we, the Lord sent us out there to do. Mm-hmm. He said, go out on the highways and the hedges and bid them to the marriage that his house may be filled, man.
That's right.
That was a commandment from the Lord, man. And also to what? To preach repentance, man. You know? Because that's first and foremost by our people to repent and turn back to the Heavenly Father, man. You know? Anything else you want to say, y'all?
That's it.
Hey, so with that, I hope brothers edified. Once again, we'll give all honor and glory and power to
Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem Rakakwadash.
Hey, double honors to our elders, our apostles, great millstone, and peace and blessings to the hope of the elect. Till next time, Shalom.
Shalom.
Wabba Ball, man.
Wabba Ball.
Yeah.